So here I am playing Aliens Colonial Marines. Right now I'm boarding the Sulaco, which is the starship from the Aliens movie that the first set of Colonial Marines used to land on a mining planet. So here we are, Colonial Marines, looking to see what happened on this, on the Sulaco. And
2-1, what is the status of 2-3?
Basically, we just walk into a shit storm here of aliens and spiders and all kinds of
got you two here.
Face huggers, I guess.
And I'm reading 2-3 to the south. Beyond the hangar, engineering perhaps.
They moving?
No.
So here I am with the famous motion detector device from Aliens. The feel of this game is very much like Doom 3. Very dark, very
could be under attack.
Frightening, giving you a lot of tingling sensations. I had it on really dark here at this part. I have to turn the light up though, because later on, because there's just no way of playing in that amount of darkness. The flashlight that's on your rifle isn't that bright, as you'll see in a minute. It's really annoying. The motion sensor, of course, comes in very handy, but you can't really use it during.
Well, he ain't saying much.
Then find me a half when you have your rifle actual out, so. But whenever there's an alien nearby, you will get a ping on the sensor. It'll pick something up, and it'll be a quick ping, and it's good warning to pull out your motion sensor and take a look around. So here I go, for some reason, all by myself, into the darkness. So I play it pretty tight right here. And, you know, when I play horror games, I tend to play them very carefully because I can jump pretty easily, and my new medication I'm on, like, I jump at the freaking sound of a car door closing. So my senses are super heightened lately with this new medication I'm on. So here you see the flashlight. It looks fairly bright here, but later on, like in some darker spots, it just seemed like it did not work at all. So here I am pulling up my sensor. I know there's an alien here somewhere. Okay, so check this hatch here. See, as it starts to get darker and darker, I feel like the flashlight works less and less. As for the controls, I pushed the sensitivity up to like 50%, which was necessary, but at the same time, kind of throws off my aim a little later, so I need to readjust that sensitivity again. So you start out with the pulse rifle. It has an underbarrel grenade launcher. You have your motion detector. Your secondary weapon by hitting Y is a shotgun. Then you have your D-pad, which controls the little grenades. I think they're thermite grenades or something. And then a pistol, which is reminiscent of a 1911. So you can see me being super cautious again. movements are a bit clunky. Definitely, I mean, this is a step backward when it comes to first-person shooters. I'd say this goes back to, like, PlayStation 2 days with the clunkiness of it. Which is a little disappointing, but, you know, it's Aliens. I mean, I could not get the game. Because I just love sci-fi that much. So here we get to use our cutting torch. Which leaves you defenseless, but unseals and seals doors as needed.
Holy shit.
Okay, so are you seeing now this is where the flashlight really doesn't work. The flashlight's on right now. See, it doesn't do shit in this darkness. It's like once you enter the alien area where they got their whatever you call it, their webby goo shit on the walls, you know, it seems like your flashlight just, it absorbs all the light or something, because right there I have the flashlight on and you can't see shit over there. See, there's a flashlight. You can look around, flashlight, hardly any flashlight. So I was scared shitless right here because of the damn fucking motion detector. You can hear the music climbing. So I thought there was an alien right around here, but really it was just tipping me off that there's a guy up there on the to the left up there. One of our guys who's dead, so I don't know why the heck he's showing up on the radar anyways. Sorry, I'm a scaredy cat. I do not like to be scared. Come on, get over there, Trav. You fucking idiot.
Cornette. Jesus, no.
So we're looking for the Rhino 2-3. I'm part of Rhino 2-2. That's just the call sign for our units. Our squads. I'm gonna go in here and see if I can find this other guy.
Someone like that. Where am I? Winner! Grab your torch. Get me the hell out of here.
God, shoot that thing! God, shoot that thing!
Now I'm fighting this thing with their hands. I do not know. Destroy the xenomorph so we can exit this area. There's the ping telling you that he's nearby. See, so there you got to see that I have the darkness way too dark because I couldn't even see that bitch right in front of me. And then I have my sensitivity way too high.
So we're gonna cut this guy out. I've located keys from Rhino 2-3. There's some bodies down here, but some are missing. There are one or two Marines missing from Rhino 2-3.
Dead. He's gone. Sit tight. I got you, buddy.
Winter, regroup what's left. Get him back to the hangar and the rest of 2-1. Do not engage.
This is keys from 2-3, sir. Our mission was to recover the flight data from the
Sublocker. I gave you that mission, and it's over. Now regroup and come.
We have to know what caused this. Flight recorder can get us that. With all due respect, sir.
My
due
squad respect means you shut your goddamn mouth and follow your orders.
Boosted the brightness a little bit.
Hell with the orders. The flight wreck isn't too far from here. We grab it, link up with Rhino 2-1. O'Neill, you still there?
Damn. Are you guys on the way back?
No. You gotta buy us 10 minutes to grab the flight wreck.
Our Marines aren't gonna die for nothing.
Got 5 to get that recorder and get back here. Keep an eye out for Bella keys. Urata Ashes Marine.
We'll keep an eye out. Thanks, O'Neill. Thanks for doing this, Winter. If you think you see movement, don't think. Just shoot.
The environment so far. Yeah, the rendering on is okay, it's not terrible. I mean, it's about Doom 3 level, but I mean, if you consider that Doom 3 came out on Xbox, the original, it's not that great.
Winter, don't miss! They're sweeping in from the right!
Sensitivity. Pulse rifle's pretty awesome.
They're climbing out from below!
To get your bullets on target. I didn't get hung up on too much. Damn, this is nice, because there's all these jagged edges and hung up on lots of stuff.
The room with the flight recorder is on the top of the stairs! I see it!
Here we go with my shotgun.
Behind us!
Grab
the flight rack! The central console! Get the flight
rack! Grab some ammunition there.
Grab, one
like, grab the flight recorder. So we know more about.
O'Neill, flight data is in route. 2 mics to you.
Affirmative, Winter. Just save the hi-fis for the bedroom. Get your ass back here.
There's no way the flight rack didn't tape the assholes that did this to the Sulaco. If we make it back with this thing, who knows what we'll find out.
There's some ammo and some body armor. It looks like I'm being hit by this fire. It's just pretty stupid of me to stand away. I'm pretty stupid when I put that shit on the fire. Okay, so that's a grenade launcher. Fairly effective. Shot across her face. I like that the shotgun's a secondary. Because if you can get enough bullets on the alien, it then pull out the shotgun as a secondary. So this is, I mean, it's not a bad game so far. It's just the first portion. So, I definitely would like to play it with some more people. I got a couple friends that were thinking about getting it, and after reading the IGN reviews or whatever, they're not as interested in it. But I mean, even if they got it down the road when it's marked down to $20 or something, it'd be fun to play with. A group of people. Play some four-player co-op.
Are you out of your damn mind? Get to the umbilical.
Some multiplayer. This is the final stand on this little part of the umbilical checkpoint. The AI is really, I mean, maybe they found some, I'm not sure. It's like shooting at some. Aliens attacking like this in this horde mode, horde portion of the game, is pretty fun. I mean, it's just what you want out of this kind of game. I'm playing on recruit here, so probably once you play on regular or veteran, then you get a lot more aliens, and it'll be even more hectic and crazy. So here we are. We made our big escape.
Flat wreck is en route to the Sephora.
In front of me is a guy I pulled off the wall earlier. So apparently he's going crazy and he pulled out his freaking thermite and blew up the alien in his chest like a fucking asshole. Instead of just dying like a regular human being, he just fucking blew us all up. Anyways. Make my climb up here as the umbilical decompresses.
Come on, reach!
What would it take for the pressure to air pressure to stabilize?
We lost the fight.
It seems like it'd be really a lot quicker than that.
He's had the recorder on him.
And this guy will be dead too, but it's just a game.
Dead.
Well, hope you guys are all enjoying this, and hopefully I'll be playing with some other guys that I know very soon. Later.